You lied, baby.
I was like, Dylan, don't talk.
That's the first thing we had silence. Dylan's notorious for 1 minute and 41 second records. Here's Bugs Ice Hockey.
Yeah, I love this.
I start the vibes off right with some Toronto music. You know the vibes.
You know the fucking vibes.
Wait, I have an idea. I know you drank that already, but for the camera, they do know because you're in the middle. You're in the middle with a half-finished drink. That's okay. We're cheers in. We're not shouting out what we're drinking because nobody pays us.
Yeah, exactly.
But you know, shout a drink to for the show.
Hey, if you want to, drink your drink, sponsor us.
A lot.
Just that simple. Shit. A dead ass.
It's just that simple. We will not gladly drink. Let's and play say that your name.
Bugs Ice Hockey in the meantime.
True North views, motherfuckers!
100% too.
When it comes to beats, I'm on site with it.
Sneaky. It is sneaky.
I take your life on
keep up body stuff.
This glizzy on my waist, take your life on you.
Yeah, it's hard.
Shake a nigga down.
Actually, like I'll click the link.
My heart be cold like this ice on me. Slide on who? This ain't ice hockey.
Jeez!
Yeah, trying to make a mill off
slide on who? This ain't ice hockey.
What?
It's a heat wave when I wave the heat.
It is hot.
Top boy like James.
I got him.
Boy with the buckets like Van Vliet.
Van Vliet.
Yeah.
That's what I play with the buckets like Van Vliet.
Then the case is weak. Like but I chase the dream.
Chase.
Can't play my team. Yeah. Get money all type of ways. Can't see my team strong like a tidal wave.
Tidal wave.
Maybe you levitate or you fade away. Cause there's levels to this shit, but don't cheat the game.
That violin went crazy. Yo, who would play the violin in the studio like that, yo?
Imagine you bring your violin to the studio.
That's crazy. That violin is going crazy right there.
Shout out to Bugs. There is an official music video for that, so check that out on YouTube. That is mixed and mastered by Foreign.Wave.
Shout out to the man.
Dups and Mulberry Prod, like producer. And then again, follow Bugs at Bugs.3 on IG. That one's called Ice Hockey, official music video. Ooh, that shit's out. That shit's hard.
Ice on me is sliding like ice hockey.
And that's a perfect way to start episode 169. I don't even know what to say at that point. Holy,
that's not Jurassic Park.
Threw me off guard still.
See, we've had to talk about this.
We've had that talk. Refer to episode 67. I'm joking. I don't know which episode it is.
But we've had that talk before where I thought it was somewhere else.
It was, but yeah.
Hey, but everyone says Jurassic Park, but I got it from somewhere else. I can't remember.
It's like,
I got it from The Hulk.
Yanny,
at the
Laurel.
End of The Hulk movie.
Yanny,
and we played both episodes. We played both of it.
Laurel.
It's like the old
Yanny.
It's exactly the same.
Yeah,
Yanny.
When the Hulk's walk is like the old Hulk.
Lord. The old one at the end, Yanny. When he's walking.
When he's like just a D's guy with green skin.
Luferino, what
if that's his ass? A bit of a mustache.
Just make a biggest man. That would be Jim or Luke.
They made him look like a beast from X-Men.
That's just
come on, man. Wrong.
They just painted the man's body green.
Whole different actor when he was smaller, though. When he was the Hulk.
That shit
was
green face.
That's funny as hell.
Actually, we haven't started.
Welcome to the episode, man. Episode 169.
169, baby.
North Views Podcast. We are Toronto's official podcast.
Official.
Discussing hip-hop, R&B, and the culture.
Culture.
If you don't know by now, I go by the name of Harris.
Olé. Olé. You know it is.
Olé.
It's Dill Dot, a.k.a. the podcast K-Dot, a.k.a. Caramel Poppy, a.k.a. the Caramel God, a.k.a. Alpha Wolf, pulled up the logo, three-pointers only, bang.
You already know me, Skirt Master here, Mr. Triple Double himself, zero assists, stealing 70 mil from the TTC.
Jeez.
If you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping. On my way to my NBA championship,
Jeez. You
can call me Just Shola. And as usual, we are here giving you our views from the perspective of a few first generation Torontonians.
See that then.
Wow. Had
to know when to add that in there, man. Follow us on our socials. Yep. As usual, before we get the show started, always follow us on our socials at True North Views on Instagram, on Twitter, and on YouTube. Of course, on our YouTube, you will find the full episodic experience, audio, visual, episode. What are we wearing, what are we drinking, whatever it is, the 7%, and that shit tastes like brisk. So it's a problem, because I can wax like 5 of these.
Yeah, easily.
And it's a big problem right now, you know what I mean? So check out our YouTube, of course, to see what we are drinking, what we are wearing, and really get that full experience. I think a lot, you guys can agree, a lot of the show has to do with how our body reacts to things, mm-hmm. things that are said, things, you know, shit that happens in the room. So I encourage all DSP listeners to check us out on YouTube because you will get in a sort of additional experience.
And low key, I'm kind of sweet still, so you know. Low key, I'm kind of sweet, so you know.
Do we need to be signed to Spotify to get our video on Spotify?
Yo.
Good question.
I've watched two videos on Spotify before.
Ack Up has a new podcast episode.
Oh, he does?
I didn't watch it. I just found out.
That's like, your favorite pod, eh?
My favorite media personality right now.
Actually, I really like Ack. He grew on me. I used to not like him.
He's made a maturity turn.
There we go.
A little bit.
All that's YouTube related stuff. So if you want to, that was Spotify, even though. But anyways, follow us on YouTube.
It was about the visuals on Spotify.
Follow us on YouTube. Subscribe to the channel. Comment all that good shit. You know, vibes there on our Instagram, of course. Episode drops.
White guy's piecing him up right now.
He's crunching him. I like it too. He's just floating with it. Yeah. He's laughing right now. Oof. IG. You will get episode drops. You will get episode notes as well. And you will also get some TMV clips on there, so definitely follow us on there.
I slept on the clips this week.
Share things on your stories. Again, like all the pictures, like all the videos, participate in the comments. We appreciate that. And on our Twitter, it's really nothing.
Just follow it.
Nothing crazy. Nothing productive. That's the word I'm looking for. It's just a bunch of random liking. Random tweeting, tweet, retweeting. Hashtag of the day, topic of the day.
You know what I'm saying?
Whatever it may
outfit
be.
Outfit of the day.
Just know that at this point, it's 169% likely that anything you see from an at True North Views Twitter account happened while I was
meditating.
Meditation, you see, is very important. Teaches you two things, awareness, acceptance. If you can get those two things popping, then we can get the show started.
That's good.
And we're here getting it started because you already got it. You know what I mean? You already got it. J. Cole was talking about meditation at one point, and he explained it pretty well. He said that the way that he views it is that he just tries to sit and be aware. So if his mind goes off racing for 30 seconds, cool. I caught it racing for 30 seconds. Mm-hmm. Now let me go back to awareness. If you start thinking about that random thing for even 5 minutes, still stay there. And then, I caught it. Okay, I'm back to this. So it's really just a practice in that. And that, again, helps you out with life, awareness, acceptance, two keys to life, allows us to get the show started. You know the vibes. We got some pre-potpourri.
Pre-potpourri.
What do we got?
Or do we just shove it all in post? Like, come on. It's one thing, no? I wanted to start on some bullshit.
Let's start with the bullshit. Okay.
Pre-potpourri.
America's fastest female.
We're talking about Dill's girl, the sixth fastest girl ever.
America.
She has a point at the end of the day. Sha'Carri Richardson, of course, we're talking about her, man. She had some issues going on earlier in the week where she liked an offensive tweet about Jamaicans.
What did they say again?
Somebody tweeted, not y'all Jamaicans. I hate when people say not y'all. Yeah. Y'all. It's one person on your timeline that said it, bro. Don't say y'all. Not y'all saying Jake Paul's going to win.
Right?
One person.
Nobody said that. You said that.
You thought about it.
And then you said y'all.
Just because you think about it doesn't mean everyone else is thinking about it.
Holy fuck, bro. You don't know much. When I read that, I get so aggravated, bro. Anyways, not y'all Jamaicans still talking shit when y'all got to walk barefoot to your coconut stand every day for a living.
That's crazy.
Yo,
that's wild.
That's crazy. Not the coconut stand.
That's so wild.
That's wild.
And Sha'Carri Richardson, she liked it. She pressed like on that tweet.
Damn.
So a lot of people were obviously feeling away. About the way she was talking down to the Jamaicans. We know that, a shout out to Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce, she ran a 10.60. Personal best at this age is insane. 10.60, so that is the third fastest time ever.
Mm. Not 10.06?
No, 10.60. Oh. For women, though.
Okay, that, yeah. I didn't think of men 10.06, but that's fast.
Mad team. So we know that FloJo ran... What she run? 10.4 something, 10.41, I think.
Oh, shit, that's fast.
We know Elaine Powell, Elaine Thompson, last week in the Olympics. She ran 10.61 in the Olympics, and then she ran a 10.53 the following week.
Oh, shit.
And then Sha'Carri Richardson just did a 10.60. Sorry, not Sha'Carri Richardson. Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce just did a 10.60.
That was 10.60 when she was back
there. So it's crazy. It's a mad thing. It's a mad thing. Shout out to the Jamaicans, of course. But yeah, Sha'Carri Richardson was wilding. And she also wilded out on... You guys don't really know who Allyson Felix is, but...
Yes, I do.
Okay.
The fuck, I watch the Olympics religiously. As of my family, since 2000, we just sit down. Track and field was like our events. We would sit down, watch that shit religiously.
Sydney 2000. Yo, I used to know every Olympic city by the year.
Mm-hmm. I used to too. Sydney.
Sydney's 2000. Athens. And then London.
Beijing.
London's 12. Yeah, Beijing
then London. Then Rio.
Then Rio.
And then before 2000 was Atlanta, 96. Atlanta, 92 was Barcelona.
Yes.
88. I can't remember. Yo, I started at Barcelona.
92 for Sega. The best fucking Olympic game ever made.
Not the one that came out this year.
Because the intro of that game was all the fucking years. And I played that game so religiously. I had it from like 46, bro. I had it. I swear to God, I had it. I'm not going to lie to you. Sha'Carri Richardson, man. She was talking some shit. So no shout out to her for that. I think she's salty.
All right. Yo, but low key, she should run barefoot more often. Mm. Tough up her foot, cause she can't run. Tough up your foot, dog.
Say that then.
Okay, well, so what did Allyson Felix say? Because I respect Allyson Felix.
Who's Allyson Felix?
Oh yeah, she was okay. Allyson Felix is one of the goats.
11
of
medals
American
in the Olympics.
Sprinting.
Okay.
She's a 400 meter specialist, but she also ran the 100 and the 200, and did great.
That's
and
wild.
Was at the top of the food chain in each of those events.
Yep. So she, but her 400 is her specialty.
Yeah, she was known for 400.
But she does 100 and 200. She's wild.
Yeah.
That's an athlete.
Trust me.
That's wild.
Different trainings. Totally different trainings. And you can do it.
400 to go to do a 100 and 200? That's crazy.
So she was on... Jimmy Kimmel. Allyson Felix was on Kimmel.
Yeah.
And she was talking about just supporting Sha'Carri Richardson. You know, athletes like this need support in these type of times, whatever. I don't want to play no clips, because it's not that entertaining to listen to. But just pretty much that. And then Sha'Carri Richardson said on Twitter, yo, saying shit on TV is mad fake. There's no point of saying it, bro. I don't fall for this shit. For lack of a better word.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it's like, bro, you're going to Allyson Felix. For what reason, bro?
Yo, that's some immaturity.
Yo, she got smoke for everybody.
That's immaturity at that point. I chuck it out to immaturity.
Free smoke. It's no excuse. She's wrong. Hey.
Yo, come on.
Allyson Felix is a gold.
Yo, honestly, like,
even if you have beef with her, you call up the phone and text her personally. You don't put that shit.
Yo, she has,
she's a gold. She deserves respect.
What's her name?
Sha'Carri Richardson.
Yo, she has a lot to say for somebody that came in seventh.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
I will say this, though. End of the day,
you got a lot to say. You should just stop talking. Personally,
end of the day, she is a world class sprinter.
Yes, 1,000%. 1,000%.
Like, that doesn't go away. You got to back up your shit talk.
Yeah, you got to back up your shit talk. You got to be able to back it up
with
your results.
The scary thing with Sha'Carri is that because she has it, she has the it factor.
She can run that one day.
This was just a really bad season for her.
It probably like the weekend probably like mentally like dreaming.
Go through a tough time
because she could turn around tomorrow. And don't get me wrong, like, in terms of these races that we've been seeing with these Jamaican women, Sha'Carri would be coming in third in each of these races,
mm-hmm.
right? It's just we have Sharika Jackson coming in third instead, which is another Jamaican sprinter, right? But she's there, like she has that ability.
She has
like,
it. Yeah.
We're not taking that from her.
Exactly.
You know, it's just Shelly-Ann's too fast. Elaine is too fast, but Shelly-Ann's on her way out. So Sha'Carri could be number two.
And she's young, so
Elaine
she's
is gonna stay number one for as long as Elaine is running.
Yeah.
She's gonna stay number one.
That is huge.
And you got Sha'Carri Richardson. You got Sha'Carri Richardson, the next crop, Sharika Jackson, Sha'Carri Richardson, and they're all vying for that number three spot right
now. And 100 meters is one of those that like you can just have a good day.
I
don't think so.
I think wait for her to be on form.
Yeah.
Americans are gonna be talking that.
And it's not gonna stop.
Americans are gonna be talking even, that. Even if
she loses after that, it's like, yeah, but we still want it now one time. But like honestly, I'm all for athletes talking shit because when I play sports, I talk shit. Yeah, I'm a shit talker.
It's part of the game.
But I can back up my shit talking. So I like when I
had it.
No, I had the sauce. Don't get it. Don't get it twisted. I still got the sauce.
I had the sauce. Now you're on the court. That sounds like Messi out here. Out here.
But yeah, sometimes you just gotta shut your mouth when you're getting wrinkled a little bit. You can't talk shit and you're getting wrinkled. That doesn't make any sense.
What the fuck is wrinkled?
Like when you
it means what it sounds like.
Like you can't talk shit when you're losing. If you're getting slapped up 3-0 in a wrinkled game and you're talking shit, they're gonna laugh at you.
My thing is, yo,
so you just gotta humble yourself.
I don't talk shit until after I've won.
Keep it exactly.
Because now you can't say keep it wait low, till you win.
Keep it low. Come back next game. Sauce them up. Like, yeah, now you can talk shit.
And then,
like,
yo, this
but the bullshit part of it is that when she is finally back on form,
yeah,
people are gonna say, yo, we love that she stayed consistent. Da 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 da. I already see it happening.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But people, the goalpost always moves. When people like something or someone, they will move that goalpost.
Especially for
times.
Women, but that's another.
That's a
topic for another day.
That's a really perfect way to get out of.
Before I end the topic, just gonna say something. So end the topic there.
Going into our music potpourri, of course. Oh, surprisingly, we are 15 minutes into the first period.
I'm not surprised.
So keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. That's quick. That went by quick. Music potpourri. We're talking about Kanye and Drake.
Yes,
we have to start the shit with Kanye and Drake.
We do, of course.
Please.
Obviously. I'm going to start with just Kanye. It's going to be quick.
This is the Drake
So he
cast.
Leaks Drake's address. Now, I say leaks in quotation because...
Do you say address or address?
Address. Address.
Address.
I can't I say, lie.
Address.
Because what's the address?
Though? Yeah,
what's
the address?
It gives you a chance to say address. Because
you address something, address. But address something, and then there's that address.
That's a wonderful word.
You're on something, Dylan. Next topic. So, yo, I say leaks because... Everyone in Toronto knows where Drake lives. Like, it's just
that's
one of
another thing that annoyed me on Twitter this week.
But because Americans don't know that.
No, but what annoyed me on Twitter this week was every Torontonian going and like everyone in the world knows that only Toronto knows Drake's address. Not y'all Americans reacting.
I can see that. Not y'all.
Y'all Americans just finding out where Drake lives when Torontonians been knowing.
But it's like everyone in LA knows. Everyone in LA knows where Kylie lives. We don't because we don't like. It's just one of those. If you're in the city,
episode name is not y'all.
Not y'all. The one that pissed me off the most is the shorties. They're like, yo, every story that's kind of bad has already been to Drake's house. We know where Drake lives. I'm like, shut your mouth.
I saw that too. Oh, like, shut your mouth. So yeah, I just say leaks just because, again, he went to Toronto. We knew where Drake lives. It's not a big deal.
I don't know where Drake lives.
I don't know where Drake lives. I know it's in Forest Hill.
No, it's not. It's on Bridal Path. To be honest, I don't know exactly. I just know it's in Bridal Path. Everyone knows it's Bridal Path. If you go through Bridal Path,
Bridal Path has the worst roads, by the way.
It's pretty bad still. Like, it's really lumpy because I've driven past there when there was dirt traffic.
Slumpy.
Yeah, but every house in that place is like mansion, gated up. You can't. You're not getting any
house. Why did Kanye feel like he had like, yo, I shared his address, guys. Yo, like
I thought it was immaturity.
I have a theory.
Okay, go.
And we can tie this into
because I'm pretty sure I may be on
Certified Lover Boy coming out and Ye coming out as well. They're just doing joint promo.
And that's why I wrote their CLB Donda hype. I'm like, yo, they're just trying to hype up their albums.
But they're literally, yo.
I believe that.
Nah, everyone knows where I live anyway.
Remember the Joker?
I'll tell you why.
Okay.
Yes.
The Joker post.
Please explain that.
The whole Joker post. Like, I don't know. I'm just saying. Like,
he did a Joker post, and then apparently, like, the way he leaked CLB was on the fucking Hacking TV.
Yeah.
Hacking TV had to do with Joker because the Joker hacked the TV. Bro.
Like, it's too much of a setup. As I saw that, I was like, yo, it's a setup.
That's not these guys edging each other. This is working in collaboration.
They're not coercing. They're not like talking about like, hey, yo, Kanye, do this.
He's pulling laughing.
They're using each other. Of course they are.
Next you gotta do is come up with a Joker.
I think they know what they're doing. They're milking the beef.
They are milking the beef. I think what they said is this. I think at the end of the day, both of these guys are business geniuses.
1,000%.
It's like Tyron Woodley and Jake Paul. They're milking the fuck out of that shit. Yes. They don't hate each other. They just want more views to get more money.
Even though they might not like each other. Even though they might not respect each other. Because we've seen genuine interviews that sounds like they don't fuck with each other.
Yeah.
If I call you but and money you don't talks. Really fuck with me. And I call you and say, yo, I know you don't really fuck with me like that. I don't give a fuck.
Let's drop this album.
Ability to rob the bank.
Yeah.
Here's what I'm thinking. You know, are you not at least open ears?
And you know Kanye's saying yes to that. And Kanye, all about money. Kanye loves his money.
I think so. I'm not, me personally, I can only speak for myself. I'm not doing anything with a guy that says, yo, I crept down the block, made a left. Like, yo, man was looking for you.
No.
I'm not working with anybody that does it.
I thought he was talking about going to Kim's house.
Kim's house. Yeah, I was going to his house when Ye wasn't there. Oh, it's going to Kim's house when Ye wasn't there.
Oh, I didn't know about that.
Like, there's like rumors that Drake fucked Kim.
It was like the whole Calabasas neighbors. Like, if you explain from where Drake lived to where Kanye is, that's the...
I thought he was trying to do a 2C slide on Kanye.
No. He was kind of hinting. Everyone thinks he's hinting that he...
He's hinting that he fucked Kim Kardashian.
Wow.
Whether with Kanye or before Kanye, either way, he was that's why Kanye got, and that's why Kanye got mad.
And even still, that adds to my point. Why would I want to work with a man that has rumblings that he fucked my wife? Because
the man's about to give you $6 million in your bank.
No.
You're divorced.
I don't care.
The man's about to add $6 million to your bank account.
Fuck them niggas for life.
He's about to add $6 million to your bank account, bro. But now,
maybe we can talk like this because we're dealing on a different scale than these guys.
A man's about to add six.
Kanye does not need Drake to make money.
Maybe.
No, he can make more money.
But they can both make more.
Exactly. That's what it is.
Let's talk from a streaming perspective. I guess. Let's say they were going to stream, and I know they're not... not exactly equal numbers. I think Drake would stream a little higher. I could be wrong.
There was actually a debate on a few podcasts about that.
Stream a little higher.
I think Drake will stream higher just because I feel like his reach is slightly. Yeah,
because we've seen Kanye slightly. Production do 200,000,
100,000. Yeah, Drake's last project was like 700.
Yeah. That's so wild. It's a whole different stratosphere.
Yeah, it is.
What are we talking about? But I forgot the point I was going to make. I can't lie.
Streaming.
Okay, let's say they were both 300,000 streaming, mm-hmm. right? But they have the ability to be at 300,000 album sales first week. Let's draw the picture better. By working with one another, they could both be, and I'm not going to make it extravagantly more, 500,000.
Put it this way, first day it drops.
Would you do it?
First day it drops, Kanye, first day it drops.
I agree with you. Don't get me wrong. I do agree with you.
I wouldn't.
But.
Yo, the man.
This is what happened.
First day it drops, Kanye's going to say some shit as, I can sell more than Drake. Every website's going to pick it up. Kanye says you can sell more than Drake. Everyone's going to start listening to both their albums. Boom, sales gone up. Of course. They're milking that shit.
They're definitely milking it, but I don't think they're milking it. As a unit.
I think to drop someone's address, you talk to the person.
They're working as a unit, bro. I don't think they're working as a unit.
Nah, once he drops the address, I'm like, yo, they're working together. Like, because Drake knows his address is not a secret.
I want to play this from Joe Budden.
Man, fuck Joe Budden. I don't care about anything that guy has to say. He's one of the biggest waste guys in this world.
Fair enough.
To me.
But why? It fits perfectly for this topic.
I think he's annoying.
Okay.
He acts condescending. He knows his shit. Don't get me wrong, but he acts condescending. Right, his fans just piss me off even more. They act like he's a god. I'm like, yo, relax. Like,
especially as a Okay.
He's a Virgo.
No.
I'm a brilliant idiots fan.
I want to play this.
That too. I'm a huge brilliant idiots fan.
That's fucking why. Because the way Schultz talks about
Schultz talks to him like
he's nothing.
Schultz hates him, bro.
And Charlamagne just lets it happen. But okay, back to the show. Joe Budden said the following. It has to do with Kendrick, obviously. But...
Oh, by the way, before you say that, I just want to say Kanye did say he's dropping on September 3rd as well.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Just in case anyone didn't know that.
I almost feel like we didn't need... But we should.
We didn't adjust. I almost feel like we didn't need to.
Yeah.
But...
I think that Kanye inspired Drake, but Kanye is a weird Drake now. So if Drake want to pow-pow, I think it would be an effective pow-pow. I don't think Drake is afraid of Kanye.
I think
all of them know that Cole just didn't give a fuck about any of them. And now the boogeyman is here.
That's true.
Kendrick. Oh, boogeyman. Kendrick.
That's true.
Kendrick's the boogeyman.
Yeah.
The Candyman. He said.
See how I just got quiet?
Yeah. Candyman is here.
See, they playing. They slap boxing.
He's not both.
They looking at the wrong.
They heard that shit.
It's been a dude. It's a stone cold killer on the loose that been quiet for years.
Mm-hmm.
And it's his final album on a very monumental imprint in hip hop. They've done everything right this entire time.
He shut shit down with a fucking Windows 3.1 fucking folder emoji.
He don't play. He's not the.
He did shut shit down with a Windows 3.1 folder emoji.
He did.
I know we weren't talking about Kendrick there. Man, I just wanted to hear the slap box part, but
he's right though.
So you okay? You think, and we'll end this part of the topic off. You think Drake and Kanye are more so going at each other rather than working together?
They're using each other's.
But just on the simplest scale, working together. Or going at each other.
They're going at each other, but they're knowing their albums are coming out.
Yeah. I think they're working together.
I think they're working together too, but he's saying they're not working together. They're just going at each other, knowing their albums are coming out.
Okay, so this is completely cooperative, intentional, and this is completely against each other.
Intentional.
Where are you?
That side.
You're on, like, are you fully here? Or are you like, you're in the
middle? No, there's no middle. There's no middle.
Where are you at? Show them.
I'm more like all the way on this side.
I feel you. I'm like here.
I can't prove it, so that's why I'm not all the way.
I'm like, that's the middle, right? That's the middle, right? I'm like, here.
Yeah, I'm more to that. I can't prove it. That's why I'm not all the way. If I can physically prove it, I'll be all the way.
Fair. Okay. Yeah, let's get off that Kanye, Drake topic. We both know they're coming out September 3rd.
C3.
And holy shit, that is crazy. Because especially if Kendrick is coming out, ooh, that is three albums that will enter the top five.
I like it.
Great.
That's what you say now. Until you hear that Kendrick song, you're like, what the fuck am I playing? Kendrick ain't dropping.
Yo, listen,
you never know. That's true.
We're going to get to that Baby Keem record in a bit.
Yeah, he could drop a Jesus is King and all of a sudden.
We're going to get to that Baby Keem record in a bit. But we do have 4 minutes left of the first period. Yes, I want to introduce this. I don't know if there's any convo that will come out of it, but I definitely want to bring it up. This is as of, let me bring up the exact date. August 22nd, we have the 2021 top hip-hop albums. So highest selling hip-hop albums released in 2021 thus far for the last 3 minutes of the first period. At number one was 777,000. At number 10.
I hope there's 10.
That is 10, right? At number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. At number 10, at 475,000, DJ Khaled.
That's Khaled.
Khaled, or whatever it was called. Okay. At number 9, 477,000, we have Slime Language 2.
Damn.
At number 8, 533,000, Lil TJ.
That surprised me. I won't lie to you.
Number 7, with 557,000, Lil Baby and Lil Durk. Number 6, 651,000, Doja Cat.
I thought that would be higher.
I don't think her album was hip hop.
It wasn't.
She raps.
But she's pop hip hop.
She raps.
She's not pop hip hop.
Yeah, pop hip hop. Definitely.
Pop. It's like pop hip hop.
I know, I get it.
It's one of those, trust me. The boards is like, it makes no sense. Pop hop.
At number 5, Rod Wave, 686,000.
He streams a lot. He has good streams. He streams billions.
Rod Wave is trash to me.
Mod.
Oh, I don't. I'm not his fan. I'm not like a super fan of his, but he streams.
Number 4 was 708,000. Polo G.
I'm just happy because a lot of people are like, oh, it has no staying power. It has no staying power.
We know he's big label, at least for now, but I think he does have staying power.
Because Migos dropped the same weekend. Where's Migos on this list?
Talk about it. Number 3 at 712,000. Pooh Shiesty.
I guess he streams well.
Pooh, you know I'm really shiesty.
Yeah. Number 2 with 723,000. We have Jermaine Cole.
Okay, not surprised.
Not surprised.
And at number 1 with 777,000, we have Moneybagg Yo.
That's still killing me. Who's he paying to put himself as number 1? Because at this point, I think he's paying people to put himself on this list so everyone goes listen to his album.
Number 1, Moneybagg Yo.
This is the second time we've had him number 1 on a list of top something.
Yeah.
He was at the top of the previous list.
Yeah,
what album did he drop this year?
He actually dropped
it. He dropped that album. And he was playlisted like crazy.
Yeah, he was
playlisted.
He had some bangers.
Time Today. Yeah, Wakisha.
I don't know that song either.
My thing
but he has some good features, though.
I would think someone like J. Cole would be over a milli by now. Like, is this how hard it is to sell a milli? Remember when Lil Wayne was doing the first week?
Yeah.
15 years ago? Physical, what, a milli? Now we're streaming, we have a milli.
Okay, let's get into this, definitely. End of the first period.
Oh, yeah,
we're supposed to be discussing this. We're definitely going to get into this, because I do have some questions as well. But yeah.
All right.
cut.
That's it. Da 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 da. Waukesha. Da 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 da. I don't know what fucking song.
He was playlisted.
He sampled the thing, man.
The song.
Da 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 da. Okay, so okay, this is what I'm confused about.
What are you confused about?
Don't we see? Okay, first album weeks called it 400. First week.
Wow, probably something like that.
Something like that. 300, I think. Let's say 300.
Let's just say 300.
Okay.
You would think the second week, 89, 90.
Yeah. But you think he's consistently putting up a 40 a week, I would think at so. Least. You
know, now, is the math just math and different in our heads than what we think? Because some of these artists I'm thinking is putting up 40K a week.
I want to go pull up these numbers.
The only person that I know that does something like that is like Post Malone and fucking Olivia Rodrigo.
And that's why I think J. Cole can do.
And Moneybag Yo.
I don't know.
And even Doja Cat. I think Doja Cat can pull at least 20 a week.
I thought Doja was pumping 80 a week.
That's what I'm saying. Like, easy top of the pop charts.
She's pop.
Like, where's Olivia Rodrigo? Wasn't she like top of the charts for like 17,000 weeks?
Oh, it's hip hop. Sorry, Marvin. That's what I'm saying though. Like people like that do those kind of numbers every week.
I'm not surprised Justin by any Bieber's. of the play. I'm only surprised by Pooh Shiesty.
Pooh, you know I'm really shiesty. I was surprised by one of the. Who was the first person I said?
That's the only one I'm surprised about.
Lil TJ. I didn't know he had like. I knew he has a fan base, but I didn't know.
Remember
it was
that
like...
song? Let it call him up. I know that song.
All the time at work.
It's so outplayed, bro. But that's the only one that surprised me was Pooh Shiesty. But yeah, with J. Cole, I thought he'd be, not to say higher, not even necessarily to say that, because I'm not expecting him to be number one. But. Mm-hmm. When you do 300 to 400 first week.
Rodrigo did 140 this week. She's number one, Olivia Rodrigo.
That's what I'm 140. Saying. 140. People like that are doing those kind of numbers. That's like 140 though, is crazy to do. And her, I don't even, when did her album come out?
Bro, who knows?
That's fucking
she
wild.
She probably don't even have an album this year, bro.
That's wild.
She don't even have an album.
Who else is up there?
Lord Trippie Redd. This is this week.
Who's in second?
Trippie Redd, because he just dropped.
How much?
75.
Wow.
Mm. Yeah, Trippie Redd is huge.
Wow.
He sells like 60 to 70 easy first album.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Who is he beefing with again?
I don't know, 6ix9ine.
Was it Academics or 6ix9ine?
He's been beefing with 6ix9ine.
It was 6ix9ine, okay. After 6ix9ine put him in the dirt, he started selling like 12 Thou Wow. He was
You're right. See, Doja Cat, she did 54 last week.
Damn.
So how was she only at Planet Rocker Pink Planet per
Planet Her per Oh, you can't click. I can't click when it came out.
The album just came out though.
Yeah, it was like what?
So I'll give her that.
It was last month.
And she didn't go crazy first week. She only did like 200 first week, I think it was. Yeah. Or less. No, less.
I can't remember. We did the numbers.
She did less than 200.
And I said 200 or some shit.
Yeah,
she did like 81.
Yeah, I guess, Lil Baby's still up there, so I can see that.
I'm not mad. Okay. I'm not mad.
Pop Smoke, Dua Lipa, Polo G. Yeah, Polo G's up there.
How much is Polo G doing? 32, I'm guessing.
Polo G, I just saw
20?
It. 21. Which is not bad. If you're putting 21, what, 2 months after your album came out, that's pretty good.
Is Cole on that list? I'm curious.
Yep, he did 14.6.
Okay, that's kind of what I expected. Yeah, I was expecting
him. And his album's been out for a while.
Yeah, I was expecting them to put up like 25 a week.
I wish they'll show your streak. They won't show the streak. There was another one I saw. It will show like how long you've been on the like top charts.
Oh, true.
So you can actually see how long the album's been out. But yeah.
It's an interesting list. But to your
point. Is Moneybag Yo there?
No, that's actually a good question.
That's a great
question.
Because I want to know. Like,
that's actually the million dollar question.
This will prove that he's actually not what he says he is.
He's
on there.
You niggas lied. Yeah,
he's on there. 17,000. He did more than Cole.
17 though.
He did more than Cole.
17 though. When did Waukesha come out? January, bro. Because at this point, it must be longevity.
Fam, he's 17. Okay, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, I have a wild question to ask it, and then we can get off the topic.
Yeah, because we've been on this topic for a minute.
Who's gonna end the year the highest
Drake.
In hip hop?
Drake,
for sure.
That's not even a question. He's gonna kill that list in his first week. He's gonna be on that list in his first
maybe
week.
I shouldn't have done Drake. Maybe I should have said who's number one. Who's gonna be number two on that list?
Kendrick,
Kanye.
Mm. If Kendrick drops, it'll be Kendrick. I think Kendrick's dropping.
I think it's gonna be Kanye. To be honest,
Cole.
Nah,
might not have enough time.
I think Kanye.
He might not have enough time.
No, I think Kanye. Kanye,
he does it.
Kanye
he
has
does.
A bigger reach than
Kendrick will drop in December, I think, and
that's not enough time.
He'll bang it out. He'll bang it out first.
Kendrick does not have the same reach as Kanye. I do want to quickly ask Kanye. About that. Like in Africa, they listen to Kanye before Kendrick.
What? For some reason, my bad. For some reason, people think Kendrick about to stream more than Drizzy type thing.
No, he's never done more than Kendrick.
Drake. Streams first week.
Kendrick streams Damn. Slightly more than Cole.
Damn was 600 first week.
Yeah,
Cole and Cole's previous something. before this Cole project.
Yeah. But that's what Cole's
previous was 450 first week.
That's what I'm saying. Kendrick still.
And Drake was 700.
700. That's what I'm saying. He's in that range still. He could do it.
600 is in that range, though.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
I just don't think Kanye...
He could do it still.
600 is in that range, still. But he's not going to
And Kendrick
that.
Hasn't
he's
dropped in, like, 17 that. Years, bro. Once he drops, it's going to go
million. What did Isaiah Rashad do, bro?
Yo, let's see Isaiah Rashad. I'll check
Yo, Kendrick out. Will do Millie first week. Hands down.
Holy fuck. No, he won't, bro.
Millie first week.
That's insane. Millie Drake is going to do 600. Kendrick's about to do 450.
Kendrick's album is gonna blow Isaiah Rashad
on the list,
and Kanye is about to do.
Yo, can we timestamp this? Because
yes,
I wanna go back to this.
Run the math. Okay, first week streaming numbers. Kendrick Lamar, go.
Millie first week.
You're nuts.
You're wild.
Okay, no, I'm
even Drake didn't do. Drake didn't do a million.
I'm gonna say eight.
You're nuts.
I still think
eight. Seven high sevens to eight.
Sure, Shola.
Like 7 to
600.
I 780. Got 450.
I got 500 to 600. Actually, I got 400 to 500. Actually,
whoa,
I got 400 to 500.
I got 450, bro.
Whoa.
Yeah, I think
that's wild.
Kanye first week
5 320.
350. Bro.
360.
Drake.
This guy changed.
360.
You're giving him some like when the numbers I was giving. Snow Allegra, you're giving some of these guys, man. Fuck.
Snow Allegra.
Yeah, I gave. But these are the 800.
Did she do good though?
These are 32.
These are the top tier artists we're talking about. These are A-listers.
Now, the main event from a streaming
Kendrick,
perspective.
Or sorry, Drake.
First week.
700.
780. Around that range.
I got 800.
Like
I wouldn't be surprised at 800.
High sevens, low eights.
Like, I'm saying 700 as a safe number.
And I don't think this is bias at all. I think it's just, like, history. No.
Yeah. His last album, which was it? Which I don't think was that great.
Which was a mixtape.
Dark Lane
did 200 though.
It came out last year,
but that was a mixtape.
And it was Lucy's.
And he promoted
and
as
he
a
even said it's Lucy's. And
it is Lucy's.
200.
That's why.
I imagine a whole ass album with a whole run.
How much did Scorpion do?
700.
Oh, yeah.
It's like 772. It wasn't like we just called 700. It was like 7. It was in this well in the 70s.
Yeah.
Or 700.
And this is
I think he's gonna do 800, bro.
Yeah.
I would. I'm not surprised if he does it.
Holy shit.
Me saying 700 just being safe.
Facts.
I fuck with Edson Barbosa, actually.
Edson Barbosa is sick. But he's facing my boy Giga Chikadze.
That guy's a demon.
This is going to be a great fucking fight.
Is this tonight?
Headliner? This is tonight.
The main event?
Oh, shit.
Edson Barbosa versus Giga Chikadze.
This guy's a demon.
Is there a belt on the line?
No, but these guys are... Giga Chikadze is top 10. Edson Barbosa, I think, is number 6
That's
in the division.
Yeah. Oh, shit. He looks Brazilian.
Nasty. He's nasty.
He's a demon. I'm going to have to watch this one, then.
Nasty with it.
Let's talk about
about Tyga's My Star.
My Star.
So My Star is Tyga's. Look, my boy Chikadze. Let's go, bang, come true.
Yeah, he has some long legs.
Ooh. Come true, dog.
He doesn't even look like he fights. Like this is a guy like out think he can take on the streets.
These Middle Eastern guys, bro.
Nah, nasty. Barbosa's
from
cooking
Georgia
him.
Or something, dog. Come true, dog.
Barbosa's cooking him still.
Nah, bro, look at this guy.
Like, if you see this guy on the street, you're like, yo, I can take this guy.
Nah, I wouldn't say.
No, not if he had like this head. No.
You look at his head shape and be like, yeah, he's crushing me still.
Look at this guy's job.
If he had a shirt on,
I'm not fighting this guy.
No,
that's what I'm saying. Like you see that doing that, you're like, yo, I can take him, and then you're off,
yo. Yeah, how you that tall? You can't fucking, climb the octagon.
You gotta practice that shit.
That's wild.
That actually looks sick. I'm gonna be shocking too. Okay, let's go.
Oh yeah,
My Star.
I called it.
Tyga My Star. You called it.
You did.
My Star is Tyga's version of OnlyFans. So Tyga,
he was an OnlyFans fan.
Tyga said to be like the owner of that and create his own OnlyFans that's going to allow specifically sexually explicit content, which you know is what OnlyFans was prohibiting.
That's fucking lit. I'm in. I'm signed up.
I hope he has the capacity of it. It's a lot of work. Like when you're hosting stuff like that, you need like a big you should have a company backing him.
No, I want to
like an Amazon type of thing backing him. It's low key quietly.
Things like that much subscriptions? That's a
yes.
lot.
Yes.
That's wild.
Girls are gonna make money.
This is gonna make Tyga's a fucking genius.
Now careful now.
Be careful.
Because I think My Star caused the following to happen.
OnlyFans
has dropped their planned porn ban. They will continue to allow sexually explicit content. I know they said it was temporary, but I don't know, it may be indefinite. Wow. OnlyFans dropped plans to ban pornography from its service less than a week after citing that they need to comply with the policies of banking partners. Interesting.
Yeah, actually, I read into that about the banking partner. They said what happens like before banks want to like help you go public, they're like they don't want
they don't want to be related to weed, porn, gambling as well, and white label.
Shout out to my bank for hooking me up with CBD Organica though.
That's surprising. If it was a major bank, that is
surprising. A major bank. Probably one of the biggest banks in Canada.
I think I know which one it is then.
What was I going to say? What I think is happening actually, to be honest, I think OnlyFans is going to build a second site. Mm. And then eventually next few months, they'll say, okay, you know, OnlyFans don't have it, but, you know, only XYZ, only but XXX.
Like, it'll be like
OnlyFans.
Horny fans.
Horny fans.
Horny fans. Horny fans. I like that.
Something, man.
That's what I would do if I was OnlyFans. I would have been like, I would have started creating a whole different website.
Horny fans is crazy. Why didn't they sister site early?
That's what I would have done.
Why didn't they sister site first?
I would have anticipated it being this big.
Did you ever do this back in the day where you asked yourself if it was Sprite or Coke that tastes better?
Yes.
Bro, the same shit.
Spider, Pepsi. You meant Sprite or 7-Up or whatever.
Pepsi
or Coke.
No. I meant like the white drink or the brown drink.
I never asked myself that. Because Sprite's better, obviously.
Sprite's just better.
Yeah, 1,000%.
Okay, fair. Okay, at least you picked the right one. I was like, wait, you guys have never asked yourself as kids if Crush tastes better than cream soda, tastes better than Crush Coke, tastes better than...
I just know this in my head.
Yeah, facts.
Maybe I did this subconsciously because I just know what to get.
My shit right there. I want that.
That's some crazy shit, man.
Shout out to Tiger, though.
It took me until I was like 17 to realize that Coke and Sprite were owned by the same company. Mm. Like Future Shop and Best Buy.
Yeah,
in the day, you used to think, are you dumb, dog?
You're Best Buy.
And then they're the same shit.
I used to work at the source.
I had source discount. I worked at Virgin.
I have that store. I worked at Virgin.
Yo, my source discount was crazy, bro. I got bear shit from the source, bro.
Can't lie, bro.
Shout out to the source.
People thought Isaiah Rashad was dissing Kendrick Lamar.
Probably.
Because he basically tweeted, so right around the time Kendrick
New Thoughts
tweeted the OK Llama thing, New Thoughts.
He said my thoughts.
He
said my, or is that Punch? Punch said my
Punch
thoughts.
Punch said my thoughts. He said Isaiah's thoughts.
Isaiah Rashad tweeted, I'm trying to find Kendrick a picture sucks of the dick. Tweet.
Whoa.
He definitely took shots then.
Oh, hold on. Where's the pic? It's coming.
Daily Double.
Okay, so he tweeted new thoughts, and then Isaiah Rashad.
Overall,
it's not loading, but basically what Isaiah Rashad was tweeting was like, get over yourself, it ain't all about you, man, we moving on, or something like that, right?
It could be Kanye related.
So a lot of people thought it was like, yo, shit, this guy is...
A little pew-pew.
This guy is dissing Kendrick Lamar, how dare
he? And then he said, nah, it was just a joke.
This is crazy. And he didn't even say it was a joke. He was actually on Breakfast Club to explain it, so I just played Breakfast Club.
And did he say it was to Kendrick?
I'll
you're in background. Oh, no, I'll just say in general.
Obviously, but it was at Kendrick.
And I believe him.
That's not a kid out of...
You like him.
Is there added pressure on you as an artist now that K-Dot is moving on from TD? I found that out.
This is a 2-minute clip. I'll play it.
The whole 2 minutes?
I don't know. Maybe I'll fast forward in bits and pieces.
I hit whatever day it was. And...
Okay.
My mom had a little verbal whatever. And I know that I said it, whatever day it was.
I want to find a question.
And I was on the way to my kid's birthday party on a Saturday, whatever day it was. And me and her mom had a little verbal whatever. And I know that I couldn't say anything I really want to say, so I said on Twitter.
Everyone in TD is short.
And I'm forgetting the niggas is watching. So I swiped it, I deleted it. Not about them or anything, but I'm like, damn, this is kind of mean. She's actually going to see this.
What'd you say?
So I said, you're embarrassing us.
You're emotional. He said, everybody emotional. You're not that special. Quit embarrassing us. Shortly after Kendrick tweeted new thoughts.
Wow. It was definitely about Kendrick.
No, it was about his baby mama. Listen.
Nah, you were going back to that.
This ain't the first time. And this
I got to
now that K-Dot is moving on from TD.
I found that out after niggas said I was dissing him on the internet the other day.
So you stayed dissing Dot. This ain't the first time. And this
I wasn't doing anything. No, I wasn't doing anything.
What did you say that they thought it was
this? I was on the way to my kid's birthday party on a Saturday, whatever day it was. And me and her mom had a little verbal whatever. And I know that I can say anything I really want to say, so I said it on Twitter for a second.
That's it, though.
And I'm forgetting the nigga.
I only bought the one pack, though.
Deleted.
I didn't know we were going to turn up. You wanted to turn up?
Or anything, but I'm like, damn, this is kind of mean. She's actually going to see this.
What'd you say?
So I said you're embarrassing us. You're emotional. You're embarrassing us.
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it either.
And then it was right after he said the thing.
Okay, so... Y'all don't believe it.
No. I think he meant it. Because
okay, if he's talking about really? his child's mother, why would he tweet it? Like, you're embarrassing you
why you embarrassing us? We're not together.
Is he not with his mom? Like, they're having an argument.
And you can't just say on the phone.
No, you're embarrassing us. They're having an argument, and then maybe it's in person, maybe it's on the phone.
That's how I know y'all are capping, bro.
And then what? So you're going to go out?
You're capping, stop.
I'm going to go away.
I'm going to tweet it.
Let me go away.
Dill is capping because... No. I read Dill's
You're
Twitter.
Embarrassing us.
I read Dill's Twitter. And a lot of shit has to do with situations, bro.
It does.
It's so but if a man can't go on Twitter after a situation,
because if you're capping, bro. If you're in the situation, capping. I would tell the person that I'm in the situation with, you're embarrassing us. Stop.
Exactly.
He said he was on the phone, no?
Oh, are they together? Like, together?
I was, if I was on the phone together, I'm like, yo, stop, you're embarrassing us. Exactly. I wouldn't go on Twitter and say, stop embarrassing us.
You're capping, bro, because you would go on Twitter.
He's capping. I would go on Twitter.
He's capping.
But I would tell...
So
would tell
I. That's why I'm like, nah, you're
nah,
super.
He's copying.
I would definitely go on Twitter, hold my hand, and be like, nah, don't do that, man.
I think he's talking about Kendrick. I think he's talking about Kendrick.
He is.
Wow.
And that's why he had to explain himself in such detail.
That's a year.
Gotta clean it up.
Okay. Fair enough. Next topic.
Nirvana. So the baby in the Nirvana cover, I forgot the name of the album. It's called Nevermind. Came out in 1991, one with the naked baby in the water.
Yeah.
The baby is now an older guy. He's suing them for child pornography.
Wow.
But this was after he retook the picture for a 20th anniversary last year. Actually, no, earlier this year, because 2021.
I'm not even mad at that, bro. If there's a lane to sue and get your bag, bro, get it.
Everyone said they've been interviewed with him, and he's always said, yeah, I've never had a problem. I actually like it, you know. Mm-hmm. He's proud
he's
of
not
it.
Gonna have a strong case.
And then now he's like saying he's child porn and child sexual exploitation. And
the man who appeared naked as a baby on the cover of Nirvana's Nevermind is suing the band for child pornography.
He said in past interviews, Eldon has spoken positively about his depiction on the album and recreated the photo to commemorate their 10th and 20th anniversaries. Now he says the photos caused him lifelong damages.
If you look at the image art itself, it's a baby in the water with a dollar bill there, right?
Yeah.
Somebody said in the comment, the baby's still chasing that.
That's a good one, yo.
That's funny.
Still chasing that.
That's funny.
That is.
Hey, man, get your coins, man.
Man, get it if you get it, man. Why not?
Get your coins, man.
We talking Toronto celebrity boxing now? Toronto celebrity boxing. Shout out to Supreme Swiss. We went to high school with one another.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So we're definitely gonna support celebrity boxing ventures.
Exactly.
That's funny as hell. Yo, can we do like the pre-fight interviews? That'd be dope.
We should.
Yo, listen, yeah. Offer it up.
We'll be a front line and center, bro.
Damn sure.
What's the other guy's name? I don't mean to be disrespectful.
I don't know.
C-Row or Connor Rowe or something like that. He's white, so I think his name's Connor.
I just said, I don't mean to be offensive. And then
he's got hands too. So I got hands too, bro. Let's
and
go.
And Dill proceeds to be offensive.
That's not offensive. He's white.
No, you're right.
You are right, though.
His name's Connor, I think.
But definitely down to do some pre-fight
interviews.
That'd be fire.
I'm down to train a man. Holla at me.
That would be so fire. You gotta train your guy. You can't get washed up in the ring, bro.
I'm down to train my.
Can't let him lose to the whites.
I'm down.
That's crazy.
I'm with it. I would love to see though. Just quick sidebar. I would love to see Toronto. Remember we talked about it at the beginning of the year.
We did.
That Toronto was up next at the time when Academics was putting some attention on us.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Still there. Up next is a few years.
Still there. We're still buzzing. I was gonna bubbling. Say bubbling. Yeah.
Yep.
Still there. I would love for this to happen, bro.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Toronto boxing. Let's go.
That'd be fire.
Still bring good.
Because quote unquote celebrity boxing has become a thing.
Yep. Yeah.
And then our guy King Sid, I'm back with another video.
We got like a lot of character. Like we have a lot of people that can sell a fight.
Sell themselves. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And garner a lot of views for that. So I think this should become a thing. And this would be a great way to start it up.
I'm with it.
I'm down for it.
I'm completely with it. But yeah, I gotta go for my boy Supreme Swiss on that. Of course,
shout out Supreme Swiss. That's what we talking about.
But I heard this Connor kid's been fucking training.
But he has MMA training. That ain't hands, I promise you, because I've seen some people that have been in my gym for years.
Yeah.
And I haven't been in my gym for years, but they train MMA and I train hands.
You can
take them out. Mm.
You can beat them in hands.
Easily.
Got you.
But on the mat is when they will beat you.
Of course. But even with kicks, one kick.
Why is your neck so hard?
Done, bro.
I feel like if somebody has some type of combat training compared to somebody that doesn't have any.
I almost disagree with that.
Honestly,
but I do agree with what you're saying. I'm not going to be ignorant. You're right.
See,
you are correct.
I would have agreed with you until I saw the, it's going to sound like a bad comparison, the Nate Robinson, Jake Paul. Because I was like, Nate Robinson's going to beat him because he's an athlete. And I was
that's not how it works, buddy.
It wasn't combat training. Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. So
I get what you're saying. MMA combat training is better than nothing.
Fighting is different. Like when you're able to breathe and slow things down when you're fighting, compared to somebody that doesn't have that cognizance to do that, you get overwhelmed. You can get overwhelmed in the ring.
Hood hands are better than MMA.
Yo, guys, because MMA hands are strategic. Hood hands are just trying to hit you out as much as possible.
That's black sick. Hands, I promise
he's black.
You.
He got the ancestors on his side.
Going up against a white man?
Yeah, you got the ancestors, bro.
Yo, they push away. There's extra force right there.
Yo, we need to reach out to Supreme Swizz, for real.
Supreme.
I'm definitely with it.
Let's go into this.
Let's talk about this Keeper League, man. I want to know if y'all are interested in this Kanye West stem player. Have you heard of it?
I've seen it like scrolling through the Instagram streets.
It,
but
it looks hella complicated. I won't lie.
It looks very complicated. I'm gonna play a little bit of the video. Before I press volume on it, Kanye has partnered with a tech company Kano to create the Donda stem player, which is a handheld device that allows you to customize any song in air quotes. The device is available for pre-order on stemplayer.com for $200 and will ship out with Donda on it.
It sounds like a good idea. It sounds like a and seeing the guy do it, I was like, it's really sick, but I'm just not a producer into music that much.
Hey, that's kind of fire still. But I think I'd get bored of it.
Yeah, that's like bop it.
I'm not gonna spend $200 on something that I've used for like a week.
If I was a music producer,
and then look,
or
split into stems.
We don't need to escalate.
This is really intricate.
Again,
this almost feels illegal.
But it's his own music, right? So it should be fine, right?
But like, what else can you use it for? You know what I'm saying? Like, can you use it for other albums, or only can you,
probably
you
can.
Only for Donda? Because
if it's only for Donda, then it's definitely popper.
It is.
Spin it.
If you want to get into music, like twist you're young, it. Sure, that's a good idea. But honestly, it's too much. It's like, I'm not a producer. I don't care about
I'm gonna say, I haven't done a keep that.
Oh, yeah, that's a keep. That's a keep.
That. I don't need that.
Especially for $300?
I don't need that shit, man. Nah, you keep real, that. Bro. I might as well just buy
for $300, buy a Fruity Loops, or what's that called? The music
Fruity Loops?
Yeah, just buy that rather than buying that. Like, and you can do the exact same thing. Trust me.
Talk about it.
I don't know, but trust me.
trust me, fam.
It's an assumption, but trust me.
I don't know, but trust me. Let's get into this new music, though, man.
New music.
Let's get into this motherfucking new music. We've been told not to say that no music has come out, because it's music that has come out.
And then
and then you corrected it. You said,
music that I don't fuck with.
Music that I don't fuck
with. I do fuck with that. And I feel like I feel like we've prefaced that. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong.
I don't think we have.
We never have. We just said no music has come out.
That's fair. Shout out to our guy, Uncle Vic, man.
Shout out to Uncle Vic.
No, we definitely appreciate the fucking regular commentary there. But yeah, out now. Meek Mill, Lil Baby, Lil Durk. They dropped a record called Sharing Locations.
I am pulling you this year. I'm not listening to singles.
You see what
like,
I mean?
I'm just like, bro, just drop the album. Like, just
give me something. Give me a project. Like, joint project.
And then I hate the single, and then it makes me not like your album, or make me think your album's going to be trash. Like, nah.
Facts. And again, my bad. I didn't do the shout out. Shout out to At Ball Till We Fall on Twitter, on Instagram, a.k.a. Alex. Need to Know Media,
Emoji.
A.k.a. Scream Man. Again, he comes up with that multi-tweeted list of new music for the week. Check him out at Ball Till We Fall on Twitter. Like I said, Meek Mill, Lil Baby, Lil Durk, they came out with a single. Baby Keem and Kendrick Lamar, of course, was a highlight single for a lot of people. That one's called Family Ties. Seven Streeter.
Are they family?
They are. They're cousins. Yeah, they are. Nephew. Cousins? Nephew?
That makes sense. I have something to talk about then.
But they, yeah.
That's the image art. Got Kendrick it. And Baby Kim as a baby.
I definitely have something to talk about then.
They,
interesting.
Anyway, we'll talk about it later.
Yeah. Seven Streeter and Bia came out with Nasty Girl, Rotimi.
Oh, shit!
Came out with an album.
I didn't see that. I gotta listen to that. Yeah, it's your guy, Rotimi. Yeah, he's Nigerian. That guy?
He's a big rich.
Fire. No,
he didn't
fire.
Sing that
part. He didn't.
He didn't sing that.
That's Trey Songz. No.
Was it Trey Songz?
I think it was Trey
Songz.
No,
it was someone else. Trey Songz sang the last
song. Oh, he did.
And then they're like, yo, we're going to think about it back. And you're like, oh my God, that's trash. We got the old guy.
After two episodes. That's funny. But the Trey Songz one was hard.
Yeah, I fucked up. How much time do you have in the period?
I can't lie, dog. We got 8 minutes still.
Wow. Yeah, you
got
to hold it for 8 minutes.
You fucked up.
Yes, like, it's fucked up. It's slide enough.
These guys installed their own mics today. And you've seen their...
But I installed yours, and yours is fine.
I haven't touched mine. You just keep...
Nah, because I got to move it around.
I like, you know,
I want to see if this will fit under. So I
just lie.
Go home. You don't have to hold it 24-7.
Yeah, or man, smart,
yo, I'm telling you, dog. This guy comes up with some ideas.
He's the most efficient man, bro. You said it.
You might have to hold it a little, but like, at least you don't have to like hold it to keep it up. Like, this that would give some support.
Ideas, bro. Fuck, dog.
Nah, every construction fam. Like, there's a problem. Like, yo, we got to fix it right now. We can't wait 3 days.
Every team needs a Shola still.
Yo, facts, bro.
You need me.
Cash Doll, Wale, Eric Bellinger came out with Single and Happy.
Oh, I skipped that.
West Side Gun came out with Hitler Wears Hermes 8.
Damn.
Although I thought they were on 2. But anyways, that's the album. But,
you know, I don't fucking know.
Wizkid came out with The Made in Lagos Deluxe.
Lagos.
Featuring Justin Bieber.
Yes. That was a single that came out last week.
A lot of people didn't like that.
Yeah, okay.
That's alright.
Okay.
Music.
Babyface Ray and Big Sean. It Ain't My Fault. That's a single. Belly came out with See You Next Wednesday. That's an album. Burna Boy and Don Jazzy came out with Question. A single. Eric Bellinger, Seven Streeter. Oh, Seven Streeter.
I'm happy that Adrians are making it
up. Out here like that.
That sounds good.
That was called What About Us. Currency came out with, you guessed it, the album.
Holy.
That was called Highest in Charge.
Is this going on one every month?
Lil Yachty came out. Okay.
Yeah, I did not. I was not
Birthday Mix 6.
Fuck that.
Oh, yeah, he's a Virgo.
It's an EP.
His birthday is on the list. Oh, we didn't do HBDs this time.
No, we
didn't.
I didn't write HBDs at the top, but it's at the bottom. Fucked
up.
That's okay.
Throw that in somewhere.
We'll do it at the end.
Exactly.
42 Doug came out with Freedom Boys Deluxe. Max B, a few records. One called Revolution, one called 75 in the Can.
Jeezy came out with Jeezy World.
That's an album.
Yes. True. I don't fuck with them. OG's part of Shoreline Mafia. It's a group of rappers. Or maybe he's not in anymore, but whatever.
Affiliated.
Yeah.
Adjacent.
Well, he was like the head of it, but I think he left.
Adjacent. Joyner Lucas and Lil TJ came out with Dreams Unfold.
Lil TJ.
Lil Tekka came out with We Love You, Tekka.
We Love You, Tekka.
That's an album. CJ Fly came out with Not What You're Expecting. That's an album. Flea Lord and Rock Marciano came out with the Delgado album.
Ooh, Smoke Dizza.
Smoke Dizza, 183rd. Oh, shout out to 183rd. And Neem Low came out with Thanks Again. That's an album. Big Body Best. So I got to listen to that.
Shout out to Big Body Best.
That one's called Tears of a Tiger. Grip came out with an album called I Died for This. That one features Eminem, Royce da 5'9".
I'm going to assume Grip is from Detroit.
I'm going to guess as well, because it seems to be that case. And James Fauntleroy came out with I Don't Want to Be Alone. That's a single. Russ came out with You Guessed It, a single.
Damn singles.
Can't Let Go is what that one's called. But, I mean, we've learned the quality.
My issue with singles, too, Russ? Is also like...
Yeah.
Can we listen to this one again?
No, man. No.
I just want to see if it got better from last week.
Bro. Fool me once, bro.
Yeah, that's true. That is true.
Fool me once, bro. Sayari the Kid came out with Settle Down. J Balvin came out with Para. Kyle Banks came out with Bad Bitch. That's a single. All three of those are singles. I'm gonna leave it at that.
I'm gonna say one because I listened to it.
I think we'll talk about it. Oh, The Godfather of Harlem Season 2, the soundtrack.
Oh, I gotta watch that show too.
It may have come out.
I keep forgetting.
And that is a reminder to watch the show.
Because right now I'm watching the Marvel shows right now.
The soundtrack. Right. I mean, we've announced the singles every time.
I'm on WandaVision now.
Is WandaVision good?
It's actually pretty good. And I'm gonna watch Loki after.
WandaVision is
good. I'm on episode 5 of WandaVision.
I think Loki.
I didn't like it at first, to be honest. But when they came back,
see the thing is that, and I've explained it. We have 2 minutes left.
I like Loki as a character better than.
1 minute left.
Wanda Vision.
Quick people. Monologue, and then we'll get off. I loved the early part of WandaVision because I can see I don't want to spoil it too much. I can see that era of TV.
Oh yeah, I get that part. That era. I just didn't like the story.
It, but I just loved enjoying that part. I was like, fuck, that this era is great. And then it really got to the show and I'm like, okay, the show's cool too.
Yeah.
But I was really
I wish they kept it only like each episode was like an era. I wish they kept it, but when they brought it back.
It looked really corny to me, so I didn't really.
Yeah, same. That's why I didn't start watching. But when I started watching, I was like, oh, I get it. I get why people like it.
Let's end the second period there, and then we're going to get into what we listened to, which shouldn't take long. And then we got some post-potpourri. Oh, man. Period three.
Bite.
Final period. Yo, this, because I haven't eaten today.
It's touching you.
Touched
me. It's hitting.
With the back home smoke illegal,
yo, too. I can't lie. But that hasn't done nothing to me. Because I'm not a fan of bowls, dog. I need to sit down and drink the wine.
Meditate, you know?
I'm more of a wine than a shot.
Yo, see, I'm a shot guy. Give me a shot. Let's get drunk ASAP.
I do both. That's it. A wine and a shot.
Tequila. Depends on the night.
Yo, tequila and wine is different, bro.
It is. I had that Casamigos.
Yo, Casamigos?
Woo. That shit is fire.
Casamigos or Henny?
Yo,
Casamigos.
Henny, Henny. Thank you.
Really drink Henny, bro?
Yes.
Henny's. I'm more of a, like, Douce. I'll even go Cavassier.
I'm a Henny guy.
Give me that Henny.
I actually think Cavassier tastes better than Henny.
Henny.
I'm dead ass too. That's the funny part.
Can I get into what we listen to? Because yes, we have 30
please,
minutes.
Please. Okay, let's get into what we
have 25 to. Minutes.
So we have a few Canadian records at first. Chem, 5 Blocks.
That's you dial on?
Wait, what?
Chem, 5 Blocks.
Oh, yeah. Chem, 5 Blocks.
Chem, 5 Blocks.
I haven't heard the song.
You haven't heard it at all?
No, I was scrolling through Instagram to find songs, and I just seen this guy pop up.
All right, this is Chem 5 Blocks.
They get a live first reaction.
Which is why you should watch this.
Let me just describe it first. Chem and Orazio teamed up for a new fast-paced trap banger, 5 Blocks.
Trap banger.
Out everywhere now. Follow Chem on Instagram at Chem, K-H-E-M, 6, the number, up. And then Twitter, Chem, 6, up. And then, whatever. Shot and edited by Orazio.
Shout out to Orazio.
Who Orazio is.
You know him?
Who is that?
I think that was your brother, though. 1-2.
I think that's his boy.
Probably.
I could be
wrong. They probably all know each other.
I don't know, man. But yeah, let's play this one. Chem 5 Blocks. They love so in the breakfast. Oh, never seen my blood. Trenches. Off white, got an off white. Integrated to a boss light. Since he only knew the tar rate. Mind show me I can walk right. In a chizzy nigga all night. The fiends say don't you sorry. Roaches running past the hall like I don't want you need to call it. Ring my line, though it's divine. It'll be a mine, the water climbs, waterfall. The cut on the climbs, never was you. Selling some work I can never.
I like his voice.
I'm not a fan of his voice. How Toronto Trap has advanced, bro.
I like that he does.
Toronto Trap was really bothering me for a bit.
His cadence is different from everybody else. Like, he has his own style.
Yeah, so I fuck with that. I wonder how he sounds on different tracks, but I was feeling that.
No, it's not bad.
I'm okay with it.
I wasn't really feeling it, to be honest.
I'm okay with it. That's cool. All right.
It wasn't bad, but...
Chem 5 Blocks. Chem nonetheless, 5 Blocks. Shout out to Chem. New music. Always got to support Toronto music.
Shout out to Toronto.
So on that.
Big up.
Let's talk about Jay Soul.
You guys fuck with Jay Soul?
I've never heard of Jay Soul.
It sounds familiar.
A few years ago, I met a girl. I don't know. A few years ago, I met a girl
party commercial.
At Rebel.
Yeah, that's Jay Soul.
And she introduced me to Jay Soul. So, and I heard, I can't remember what song he had at the time, but it's pretty fire. And then it's like, that was like 4 years ago. So I haven't heard of him since 4 years.
And then his name popped up. Oh, shit.
Popped up. I'm like, you know what? Let's see what we got. I never heard the song yet either. So another live first reaction.
Jay Soul. Okay, let's play that. How you say you love me when you left me hanging? I took you out the hood, I showed you different places. We was in Miami, we was Ace of Spain. Chilling by the beach way before this fame shit. It's so sad how this life goes. When you fall off, everyone goes ghost. It's just so sad how this shit unfold. You was my baby, how the fuck could you go? He's saying some real shit, though, bro.
That shit sound fire.
The first thing that popped out to me was the writing.
Yeah.
I was like, he said, like, I'm not saying like he's fucking Wizard Kelly with it, but like it's like
it's connect, it's hitting. I'm trying
to say Wizard Kelly. Kelly. I don't know where I came with that.
Is it Wizard Kelly from Proud Family?
Yeah. Have you never seen his face?
Guy, yeah, he's like a basketball player.
Michael Jordan, you never seen his face.
That's funny as
hell. We know Wizard Kelly is Michael Jordan, guys. We know Proud Family.
No, it's not.
Wizard, that's what I thought.
I like that. Though. I really like that.
I'm feeling that.
I might come back to that.
Yeah, it's kind of fire.
Hikey, I will come
I'm feeling that. I'll be honest with you. In terms of what we have on this list, I only have conversation about Baby Keem and Belly and West Side Gun.
I added something in there. So really quick. Like I don't have like deep. So
I have something to say about Tekka and Jackboy. Jackboy may be a long, longer than Tekka, but they're all going to be short.
Like. I feel like Baby Keem will be a little bit of a convo, so I want to save that a little
okay.
bit.
Okay.
Well, let me start with Tekka actually.
Yeah, let's start with Tekka.
So this was We Love Tekka's 2. And it was a big snooze fest, I will tell you that.
He's trash, bro.
It was
bro,
20 like, songs.
The single's hard, though. Correct me if I'm wrong.
The singles are hard. What's
the single?
I don't know what it is, but I saw something on Rap Caviar. I'm like, this is kind of hard.
Yo, so, the kid is trash, bro.
The thing about him is like, I don't say he's trash. He's just like...
Young.
He's basic. He's young and big. All his songs are basic.
It sounds like trash.
Nah, I can't call him trash.
He's basic. he's not good. He's just basic.
Yeah, he's basic.
That's trash.
That's not trash.
Well, but is it average or below average?
Oh, it's definitely below average.
It's trash.
The features definitely carry this album. Mm. There was track number 2 with Gunna. That was called Repeated. Track number 9 called Chopper Shoot the Loudest with Chief Keef. And that song was fire. Chief Keef and Trippie Redd.
That sounds kind of fire.
That's what I'm
Chief
thinking about.
Chief Keef and Trippie Redd.
That's the song. I was like, this shit is hard.
That was probably the hardest song on the album.
That sounds like a hard song.
That shit was hard, bro. That record was hard.
There was a Nav track called About You. That was track 11. I like Nav's verse. And then Bank Teller featuring Lil Yachty. I like that Lil Yachty on that.
Okay.
Mm. But honestly, when he was on, I was just like, bro, like... You sound like, what was that, his blow-up song? That's exactly how every song sounds
broccoli?
Like.
Broccoli?
No, not Lil Yachty. Tekka's blow-up song, whichever one it was. It was pretty much just like...
It's gonna be a robbery. So it's not Snatch Your Chain.
No, that's Lil TJ and Apollo G.
They're the same to me, too, bro.
Nah, what? Lil TJ and Apollo G?
No, Lil Tekka and Lil TJ.
They do totally different community. Lil TJ sings.
I know, but they're both trash. Like, they're both in that same. Not the trash. They're not trash, but they're the same.
Anyway, all I'll say about Lil Tekka is I've already put him in that category of he doesn't separate himself from the rest. Mm. So he's just on the shelf, and I probably won't listen to him until someone says, yo, that Lil Tekka shit was fire.
Or until he gets good, bro. Like,
again, until someone says the shit is fire.
Yeah, just. Yeah. But people do say, yo, Lil Tekka's hard.
Okay, not
people
like,
do.
Good people. Like, people are reputable people. Okay. Not his fans.
Gotcha.
Two albums I barely have commentary on. CJ Fly came out with an album called Not What You're Expecting.
I fuck with CJ Fly.
24 songs, 64 minutes. It kind of just feels like music that was put together, which I'm not mad at. I wouldn't say it blew me away. I wouldn't say it was something where I'm like, yo, go listen to that. I would still recommend Rude Boy instead, his 2020 album.
Last year, we talked about it.
Yeah, we did.
Definitely.
I would definitely recommend that if I'm trying to get somebody into CJ Fly. But, you know, as somebody who now listens to CJ Fly, I'm like, oh, cool. It's just 24 CJ Fly records. I'm with it.
64, that's a long time.
I'm down. That's a long motherfucking time. I'll tell you that much. West Side Gun as well came out with Hitler Wears Hermes 8, Sincerely Adolf. That one's 13 songs, 40 minutes. I will say it's high level. It's high level. It's West Side Gun's MO, which we know is
boom, 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 boom.
Soul samples. Fucking monologues and boom, 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 booms. For some reason, that sounds disrespectful, but I will say all of the Stove God Cooks features on this album sound super fire. Stove God, he's kind of in that.
Oh, he's a rapper. I thought he was, I didn't know who he was. I'm like, what the fuck
he's
the
in
Stove
that
God?
Adjacent subgenre of hip hop in terms of like they all fuck with each other, West Side and Stove God and Boldy James and all those guys, right? Dead.
That's great.
But yeah, the West Side album is pretty fucking solid. I gave it, say, 2 or 3 listens. I know I never really give extended commentary on these Griselda artists.
But you know what you're getting a lot.
Yeah. But yeah,
it's either good or it's
getting.
Bad. And you know what you're getting.
It fits in that quality of you know what the fuck you're getting. So, if you're a West Side fan, you know what this is. And you know it's going to be high quality. So I'm going to just leave it at that.
Here we go. Right?
Hitler Wears Hermes 8. I would recommend it as a listen. I would recommend trying it out.
I like him, so I'll probably listen to it.
Definitely give that one a listen. Other than that, let's talk about...
I have a
Which one do you want to talk
Jack
about?
Boy?
No, no,
Jack
that's Boy? No, that's me. I can talk about Jack Boy. Just
Boslin?
Boslin? Right there.
Yeah, I don't even know who the fuck this kid is.
Okay.
I literally I have no fucking idea who this kid is, but I randomly, accidentally stumbled onto his music the other day. And I'm like,
this you didn't.
They put in a Canadian artist?
That's just kind of hard. No, I don't think he's Canadian.
Because, yeah, okay.
Boslin.
But I'm like, yo, this shit's actually kind of hard. Like, there's a lot. It's a, it feels kind of like Juice WRLD-esque-ish.
Well, it is called From Dusk to Dawn.
You're selling me. If you say Juice WRLD, you know you're selling me.
It's very Juice WRLD-y. What's that? Kid Leroy-ish. Kid Leroy.
Ooh, you're selling me. 12 you're selling
songs,
me.
33 minutes. But
the song that really stuck out to me is the track with Vori.
That one's called Forsaken.
Forsaken.
Let's That's play a bit of that.
Yeah, so play it at like 35, 40 seconds.
This is gonna be taken down. This is Universal Music Group.
And by the way, he's from. When I get closer to
you, you knew me better, yeah. Okay.
He's from Vancouver, actually.
Whoa, really? Yo, yeah. shout to Boslin,
because he has Vori on the record.
Vori's Canadian,
yeah. Isn't he?
I think so.
Really?
I'm pretty fucking sure.
Nah, stop this. I fuck with Vori.
It sounds like, man. Vori sounds like a Canadian name, bro.
Well, shout to Vori. Shout to Vori. Shout to Boslin. This shit's fire. I would I'm definitely going to be listening from now on.
Vori's an American singer.
Okay.
It says right there on Wikipedia.
But they're going crazy. But he has, like, a lot of different sounds on it. So, like, that's like one sound. Like, mm-hmm. The next track sounds completely
that's
different.
That's good, then. I like people
he's
like
really,
that.
He's really fucking talented, man.
Shout out to him. We got 15 minutes.
I want to talk about Jack Boy. We'll be quick. Jack Boy, 15 songs, 38 minutes. I found this on Axe page. I've listened to a few of his songs the last few months, and he's been surprising me. I like he has like a weird voice, almost like Kodak, but like a lot smoother.
That's his brother, no?
They used to be best friends, now they're beefing.
Oh shit.
It's hype music for sure, but he has very good flows. His lyrics are not gonna blow you away. And like, there's a track like track three where he's like, niggas always complaining because they ain't been through shit. I'm like, okay, makes sense. And the next thing he goes, he's like, when I fight or when life gets you tough or when life gets tough, I don't back down. I continue to fight. And I'm like, okay. And then he says, when life gets tough, I don't back down. I pick up my gun. I'm like, bro. this one's like that. Like, he gets you like, okay, no, not bad. And he says something about a gun or a girl. Track number one, I forgot the name, but I liked it. It set the energy really well. Track number 9. Now, that featured Fireboy DML. Best track on this album. Can you play back from 2 minutes, please?
Jack Boy.
Fireboy DML is a Nigerian artist, by the way, too. And I thought he sounded crazy on this.
That's why you're sponsored by Team Nigeria.
I've been sponsored by Team Nigeria.
This guy talking about listening to Rotimi.
Yo, Fireboy DML was on this.
Fuck. It's called Jack Boy 2, right?
Yes.
Okay. Track 9. Was that Kishiko?
I told her I won't change and be the same no matter what. She couldn't say the same, cause that bitch ain't what
she got. This is Jack Boy.
You're not the same. And that body move the body for me, Okumato. This one up is for smoking in our bottles.
She
gon' leave you bleeding, she gon' leave you in Okumato.
This is Empire, and Empire is definitely...
Oh, they're going to have to take it down for sure.
Yeah, what's going on in Nigeria, bro?
Fam,
crazy. They're putting some artists out, man.
Music is crazy. And then there's track 15, Changing, where he does more of a singing type of thing. And about this album, it was really highly produced.
Like, mixtape don't exist anymore, I don't think.
Whatever. But technically, this is not...
Bodies of Music.
Yeah. Whatever.
Unfortunately.
This project...
refers to stream, river, lake, ocean...
Body of music.
I missed the mixtape era though. That was an era.
I was pleasantly surprised. I nodded my head the whole way through. He gave me different sounding songs on this. He tries, throwing his voice sometimes. And yeah, I just didn't feel tired. I've actually listened to this album a few times already, or a mixtape or project. So, it's Jack Boy 2. Go listen to it with open ears. You might leave.
Okay.
Yo, do you think Dana White can fight?
No.
Because he can fight as much as Vince McMahon can fight.
Isn't that crazy?
No.
You think Roger Goodell can play football?
No.
You think Adam Silver can play basketball?
No. Yes.
No.
You think Greg?
No.
He got that body type.
You think Popovich can play basketball? I look at D2 college.
Popovich played in the army, bro.
Yo, Popovich.
Yeah, Popovich played for like his
belly. Belly. See you next Wednesday.
Hey, we don't have time to talk about Popovich right now. 15 minutes max.
See you next Wednesday. 15 songs, 41 minutes. I'll get through a lot of the commentary on here. There's a lot of Weekend.
Yeah, I noticed that too, especially on the ad-libs.
A lot of Weekend.
Ad-libs, every ad-lib was like Weekend singing. I'm like, bro. Mm-hmm.
Or it was either Weekend or Weekend-esque.
Well, mm-hmm. I think Belly, well, I know that Belly writes for the Weekend, so he can do that too.
Yeah, they're all signed to Cash. They're always together.
That makes me think that Weekend was spending a lot of time with him in Calabasas, probably,
definitely, or wherever 100%. He lives. They help Belly on his album. Like he's part of the EXO label.
Weekend, Young Thug, Moneybagg Yo, Gunna, TMB Rock, Nas, Nav, Lil Uzi Vert, Big Sean.
Uzi, I like the Uzi track.
I didn't listen to it yet.
Those are the features that are on here. I always thoroughly enjoy the respect that Belly gets in the hip hop community.
Yeah.
Obviously, being a Canadian artist, somebody who has made a name for himself in a slow burn fashion.
He's been around for a long
time. In a slow burn fashion. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he has that respect. Yep. So we were bumping him on Much Vibe.
Yeah, Much Vibe.
Back
that,
then.
With Masari. What's that track with Masari that he had?
God. Let's pop a bottle.
That song was hard.
That's a banger.
That song was hard.
I fucking hated that song so much.
Of course you did.
The track with The Weeknd I thought was the perfect hip-hop radio song.
The Nas one?
The first one. Better Believe.
Oh, Better Believe.
I thought a lot of these were like...
Like it was... Yeah,
These were like made for the radio.
That
they're trying to get one, two hits. No,
but
out
that's the thing, though.
I think that's his. I think that is his formula.
That is his.
Belly
style.
Writes those songs for The Weeknd. Like they've been working on these together.
Yes.
So he's like, you know what? I'm gonna start doing them for myself now.
And it feels very his approach to this feels intentional. Mm-hmm. Like it feels
very
like
intentional.
I want every song to sound the same.
Yeah.
I want every song to fit this script, this formula.
Mm-hmm.
I want it to fit the radio. I want it to play on hip hop radio.
Yeah.
Whether it's your local radio station or whether it's Galaxy on channel 958 on Rogers.
Galaxy hip hop.
That's funny stuff.
Yo, when I was a kid, I remember I bumped that 1-2 times.
Those went hard.
I used to bump Galaxy, bro. What?
Those went hard as shit.
That was my
bro.
Shit.
But I mean, to me, that was the only commentary that I had about this. Is as I was listening to it, and as a result of him going for that, naturally, I don't love hip hop radio.
And that's how I felt too, because you keep it a certain way. It sounds like you're not yourself.
You're
in a box.
It's my argument about Bruno Mars.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly, because he's trying to be pop. He has to put himself in a box.
So I can acknowledge it. Art. I can definitely acknowledge the art that's in it. But I'll give you that still because that was pretty funny.
Go watch on YouTube. That was a visual joke.
Hey, I'll give you that too because that is a visual joke.
Yeah, I haven't had a steak in so long.
Sometimes I see them IG pages. Them shit don't look appealing to me. Steaks, bro.
I don't know.
I need to be in the mood.
That one looked crazy.
You just see this fucking fried thing on the table and you're just like, yo. That's no different than human dog. You're damn near cannibal for different types of animal, bro.
That's cool. Why men are switching to vegetarian, bro.
I love animal meat.
Yo,
that's just delicious.
I get
meat, chicken, meat, cow, meat.
I'm still young
pork.
Burger, still, don't get me wrong. Still, but sometimes I look at like
scrim.
The nice slab of meat and they cut it, and I'm like,
bro, meat is meat, bro.
Not doing it for
delicious,
me.
Man.
Meat is meat. You can
not doing it
if you can eat a cow, you can eat a human.
Probably tastes a little
different.
Those
are the same people that say right. Got milk and trying to sell milk because they're afraid of the almond milk industry, bro. Right. Stop, bro. All
right. If Gordon Ramsay doesn't chef up a human to the
Baby Keem Kendrick.
5 minutes on Baby Keem.
We got a fucking Gordon Ramsay rant.
Five minutes of Baby Keem Kendrick Lamar. That one's called Family Ties.
Oh, I had something to say about this.
I only heard this once.
I don't know how to feel about Kendrick's voice yet. That's all I'm going to say.
I've only heard this once, so...
I don't know how to feel about Kendrick's verse.
Baby Keem sounds amazing,
though. A lot of
people
are excited about it. And Baby Keem is not as good as Kendrick.
He sounds great. He sounds really fucking... This is probably my first time I've actually listened to a Baby Keem song.
You didn't hear Orange Soda?
Nope.
Bitch, sit down, I'm a bat.
Nope.
Yeah, everyone's just...
Oh my God, everyone's just noticing it.
Everyone's referencing records that nobody...
That was like his blow-up track, Orange Soda.
Okay.
It came out last year. Yeah, it was pretty good, actually.
He can rap. He's a rapper.
He's decent. He showed me that he can be an artist. That's what he showed me on this record, is that he can be an artist.
Supposedly he used to write for Kendrick.
No,
not like right for Kendrick, like right with Kendrick.
Stop. Type of thing.
Not like okay, right with. Not, I believe four. With.
Yeah, you can hear it. You can hear it in this.
Not like four, just with. I'll say with Kendrick.
That's his cousin, no?
Yeah, they're like cousins. They're nephews. Kendrick
helped him wrote this.
Maybe.
But when that song came out, everyone was saying like they were trying to hide the fact that they're related because he didn't want to say, oh, nepotism is what.
Denzel Washington's son.
Mm. Yeah, they're like, it's not nepotism. He doesn't go by Washington, too. He goes by John David or something.
Yeah, David Johnson.
That's weird.
Because
my dad was Denzel Washington, bro.
Denzel's son.
I'm using all the nepotism, bro.
I'm like, it's one of those things that they want to get it on their own.
I'm abusing.
They don't. They don't want saying.
And
they don't even want saying like, oh, it's because of your dad. You're here. It's because of your dad. You're here. He's like,
so
nah.
What?
Nah,
fuck it, bro. I'm here.
To some people, that means something. To me, like they want their own shit, ownership, man. Kenneth. Jackie Chan not giving his children anything. Look at what if that? What if he was waiting for that?
Not a dime, bro.
Stone Cold Killer.
That's rough.
Wait, yo, that's, even, yeah, we have 5 minutes.
Kendrick did mention PG Lang on this.
Yes,
so I think we were right about.
It's his label.
Remember we saw the website?
Oh yeah,
very cryptic. I think we kind of called that for what it was.
It is his label.
Like we saw that happening.
Yeah.
And he mentioned PG Lang.
Promoting that shit.
So Baby Keem is PG Lang? Because I was looking at...
No, that makes sense.
My phone's dead, but I was looking at the credits on Apple Music.
I'm about to go do that right now.
At the song, it said PG Lang at the bottom.
I did not notice
that. Oh, shit. I'm about to do that right now.
I did not notice that.
So I think that Baby Keem will be one of his artists.
Probably his first artist. Let me see Orange Soda.
Let's see that Family Ties. See what it says on here.
It says Baby LLC. Keem LLC and PG Bang LLC in exclusive with Columbia and Sony.
Oh, that's an exclusive license.
That's probably just to like release the music.
To Columbia Records, a division of Sony Music. Wow.
Where's his Orange Soda?
That intrigues me. I don't even know why.
That's interesting.
2018, his album was Baby Keem LLC. 2019, he had a single, Baby Keem LLC. 2020 was in PG Lang already.
Whoa. Oh.
Orange Soda, there we go. Orange Soda 2019.
We're learning some shit today.
Interesting.
Yeah. So you had a song that came out September 18 last year, and it was under Baby Keem and PG Lang. Weird. Same thing. We're under exclusive license to Columbia.
We're learning some shit today.
But like, I always know that whenever all these artists say they're starting a record label, they've always signed someone already. They don't just say, okay, guys, I'm starting today.
But you gotta come up with a release, right?
Yeah.
You don't just announce the company. You come up with the company and the product.
Yeah, exactly. There we go. I like that. You said that.
But yeah, no, I mean, decent record. I can definitely play this one a few times. I have already.
I liked it when I heard it the one time, so I'm not going to complain. Kendrick's
verse was solid.
You think Kendrick's bike?
It wasn't the blowaway verse that everyone's saying.
It's like, oh my god,
but like, it's Kendrick.
Everyone
blows up Kendrick.
I'm not a trending topic, I'm a prophet.
Oh my god, Kendrick said that? Shut the fuck up. Shut down the internet, bro.
Yeah, one quotable line.
Shut down the internet.
It's just good to hear him rapping.
It is. I'm intentionally hating. It is good to hear Kendrick back. He definitely sounds like he's in shape.
Okay.
That's the best way I like to put
he's
it.
He's in shape.
You're gonna come out with a few features and just gonna be like warming up.
Huh? Lil Wayne is in exquisite shape.
What was he on this album?
No, in general. Just in general, man.
That missed a Lil Wayne track?
No, side note. You missed a Lil Wayne feature though somewhere.
What?
I think on the Belly? Who had him?
Someone he was on Belly.
I don't remember who.
The Uzi's verse on Belly I liked a lot. I played that back a few times.
I liked that. Especially after I didn't like the last Uzi record with Isaiah Rashad.
I like that too.
I hate that song.
I like Uzi a lot though. That's the thing.
Track 3, bro. Rotation.
Sir.
Let's just end off there.
My phone's dead.
Mine's going to be super light. Like, it's the same thing like last week. It's going to be 3 albums probably.
Please go ahead.
I just got to see. They were recently played. I'll start from here. So I'm going to put Jack Boy because I have listened to that a few times. Apollo, which is Fireboy DML, shout out to Nigeria. That's his album. After I heard him on Jackboy, I had to go listen to his album. Playlist. Ooh, Misery Lake by Black Bear. That came out a few weeks ago. We didn't review it, but I listened to that. And Late Night Jazz, of course. And that's about it, to be honest. That's cool. It. Just podcasting to audiobook, bumping that shit.
I bumped King's Disease.
I need to bump.
1000%. That's my album of the year.
Forgetting to listening.
By far right now.
It's on my list always, like, I'm going to listen to it and never do it.
What else was I listening to? I was listening to Her in my back of my mind, in her feelings.
Ugh, those feels again.
What else? Snow Allegra, for sure. Ugh,
those feels again.
What else? I don't fucking know. Yeah, my phone's dead, so I don't know.
I bumped Call Me If You Get Lost by Tyler. I wanted to try to bump some of the albums I do have on the upper echelon for the year. I bumped 25 by G Herbo.
I should do that too.
I bumped Bon Fidus.
Get a better
My Vibes Cartel
understanding of my top tier albums.
I bumped Good Kid Mad City by Kendrick.
Fire.
I bumped Free National self-titled project. I went back to 2018 when I get home, Solange.
Ugh.
Those feel. I bombed Off Season by Cole. Mm. House is Burning by Isaiah Rashad. Kind of it. That's kind of it. That's kind of it. We got like 2 minutes.
Oh, and that Trippie Redd album is good too. I was listening.
I heard it was good. I didn't listen to it, but I heard it was good.
It's not bad. That track with Uzi. He has a track with Uzi on there. It's fire.
Of course.
2 minute post potpourri gambling in Ontario. What are we talking about?
Oh, I was just gonna say. I thought it was something there, but
Proline has an online app now, bro. That should be looking like Bet365, bro.
They said real? They said this, yes. They opened up.
That shit looks mad.
They opened up on.
Yeah, I'm on that.
Yeah, that shit look. Proline, dog? That
that's
shit
crazy.
They opened up single event betting.
Yes.
And they said it went crazy the first day already.
Yo, of course.
But like, it went crazy.
Of course.
That's what the guy said.
Fans
so.
Are here using FunBet.
I know, right?
FunBet. What's FunBet?
I don't even know. I was about to ask you. Like,
I know, right? I was like, no.
Yeah, what's FunBet?
So, oh, man. That's all it was. Just, you know, gambling. You can gamble.
So, I don't get it. What's the...
Just, you can... Toronto here. App in Ontario.
Yeah, that's it. It's legal.
It's legal.
Oh, it's legal.
Invest in the score. Oh, fight predictions.
Didn't they get bought by someone?
They went up 75%.
They got bought by someone. How many?
2 weeks ago. Fight predictions. Fight predictions after they happened. We're going to talk about one popular fight that's going to happen on Sunday, or I mean 1 day ago.
yesterday.
Jake Paul taking on Tyron Woodley. Just very quick prediction because we don't really have too much time to extend on it. No. But I'm going Tyron Woodley. I'm going Tyron. I think Tyron is going to do what Nate Robinson couldn't.
Well, Tyron's an elite fighter. Yeah, well, was. I don't know if he...
MMA fighter.
Yeah, I guess.
And that's going to be my point about MMA dudes versus people with hands.
Because even though he doesn't have that much boxing experience.
And hood hands as well. Don't
but
get
he does
up.
Have... So, we'll see. But let's end on that note, man. Let's end on that. We actually all have Tyron Woodley. Wow, okay. Let's end on that note before we get cut off by the video. Please cue the video. Please cue the song, I mean. Because with that said, that will take us to the end. The unfortunate end of another episode of the True North Views podcast. We appreciate you guys listening, and we definitely would appreciate if you guys did all of that algorithmic stuff that would help us out. Subscribe to the channel, follow us on all the socials, comment on everything that you see, share everything any way that you can. We definitely would appreciate that. Now, as usual, I go by the name of Harris.
You already know what it is. It's Dill Dot, aka the podcast K Dot, aka Caramel Poppy, aka the Caramel God, aka Alpha Wolf. Pulling up from the logo. 3 pointers only. Bang, bang, bang.
Okay. You know me. Skirt Master. Mr. Triple Double. No assist. Cheers. Team 64 Mel from the TTC. Cheers. On my way to an NBA champion. If you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping. Cheers. They call me Just Shola in case you didn't know.
Please just tell them that number one rule.
Watch out for the Wastemans.
Watch out for the motherfucking Wastemans. You guys know the vibes already. We appreciate you guys listening. Episode 169.
Do we have time?
We don't, unfortunately. We're taking a minor break.
There we go.
We're taking a minor break, guys, as this video is going to cut out soon. We are taking a minor break. We are revamping the show.
Interview's coming, though.
We got some shit happening. That, yeah, we're still active.
We're still active, just not weekly
but
episodes.
The show is going to take a little hiatus.
This is the season
to get some
finale.
Shit right.
Yeah.
Episode season one finale.
Season one finale.
It's a manga. It's a
400 episode seasons.
A 169 episode season. But we do intend to come back stronger.
We will.
We will come back stronger.
Better,
refreshed
bigger,
imagery,
better.
Refreshed website. Merch is finally coming.
Jeez.
All of that shit will happen.
A set.
But that requires us to take some time off.
Yeah.
So that's what we will be doing. It's a True North Views podcast episode 169.
169.
I have some pasta today.
Peace.
Yeah, I make a sick tuna pasta, bro.
Yeah.
I don't fuck with tuna and pasta.
With the Alfredo and the extra cheese?
Nah,
come on.
I don't fuck with tuna and pasta. Give me shrimp. It.